Hey Fit Fam, Karen here. Just wanted to do a little bit of a informal video with you guys. Just here in my bedroom reflecting on some things going on. And one of the things that I wanted to talk about really quick was the fact that President Trump has named today the National Day of Prayer. So just hear me out for a second. While I want to respect everybody's different views on religion and things, I just wanted to share this message. In the Bible, it does talk a lot about how we are the salt and the light of the world. So how I interpret this and the message I want to relay here is this. In being the light, we are showing the world our love, being courageous, banding together because we are all in this together, and we are not alone ever. And I think it's important that we remain in the light in the dark times, especially because that's what we are called to do here. But fear of the unknown is crippling to some people, especially people who already suffer with anxiety and depression. So in the Bible, it does call us to be faithful in times of fear and to charge forth into the unknown. And as far as being the salt of the world, I mean, think about it. What does salt do? It gives things flavor, right? Never boring. And then it also preserves things. I mean, back in the day, salt was such a big commodity, and it meant that you were very wealthy because you had the capability of preserving your foods and things like that. So being the salt of the world to me just means doing things like this, charging forth in positivity, sharing your knowledge and passions, and just reaching out to those people and giving them support that may need it. It doesn't matter if you have 12,000 people following you or 5 people following you. Some of us are stronger in different points of our life than others. And if you could find that inner strength and charge forth, we're not meant to retreat in times like this. We're supposed to band together. We're all in this together, like I said, and fight and not succumb to the fear, guys. So I hope that makes sense. I'm just rambling here, but these are some thoughts that I had swirling around that I wanted to get out there to share to you guys. So in light of all this, I was hoping to do maybe 1 to 2 live streams a week with you guys, probably over on the YouTube channel, just kind of discussing our feelings and our concerns and just being there for each other. Also, I can share the knowledge I have on how to build immunity. But like I always preach to you guys, the best thing to do is to take care of yourself, mind, body, soul. The better you take care of yourself, the better your immunity and your first line of defense. So I would like to do some live streams just going over those tips and briefly, like I said, sleep, nutrition, moving the bodies. Don't be afraid to get out there in that fresh air. Working out at home. I could actually even do some live workouts if you guys want. Let me know in the comments below what would be helpful. I'm here to serve you all and to let you know that you're never alone. So give me some ideas, guys. What can I help you with? I just want to help spread the peace, the love, the light, tone down the panic a little bit, and just chill. Just do what you should be doing every day, which is just taking care of yourself and each other and your loved ones. And thank God for social media, because we can use it for good, guys. It doesn't have to be doom and gloom and crazy news and scary stuff all the time. We can use it for the good battle. Okay, so as we charge forth with our shields up, warrior status, in this week to come, remember, give each other some grace. This is all new to all of us, teachers, health professionals. Pray for them as they try to still educate and heal in this crazy time, because it's new to all of us. So remember, be the light, be the salt in any way that you can from your space and in your current situation. Always choose love, always choose hope and peace. Much love, guys. Be talking to you soon. Have a great night.